Hello and welcome. This is Chandni Nevdani and you are watching It's Tomorrow News. Largest dust storm in 50 years headed towards the US this week. A vast cloud of Sahara dust is blanketing the Caribbean as it heads to the US with a size and concentration that experts say hasn't been seen in half a century. Air quality across most of the region fell to record hazardous levels, and experts who nicknamed the event the Godzilla Dust Cloud warn people to stay indoors and use air filters if they have one. The gigantic plume is crossing the 8,000 kilometers journey to the US this week. Most of the dust is staying suspended between 15 to 30,000 feet in the atmosphere. This will likely prove to be troublesome for pilots flying through and around it, and it will also lead to hazy conditions all across the eastern seaboard and deep south when it arrives this week. While the majority of the dust will remain suspended under perfect conditions, some of it can reach the surface causing decreased air quality. On occasion, raindrops also contain the dust particles that can be seen when raindrops evaporate on things such as your car. This all depends on the concentration of dust of an area. Based on models, the highest likelihood of that happening would be along the Gulf Coast states where dust will be thicker. The most common side effects from Saharan dust is the well-known brilliant orange sunsets and sunrises, thanks to the dust particles scattering certain wavelengths of light. This is the most significant event in the past 50 years. Conditions are dangerous in many Caribbean islands. Scientists are working with NASA to develop an alert system for the arrival of Sahara dust. The main international airport in San Juan was reporting only 8 kilometers of visibility. The mass of the extremely dry and dusty air known as the Saharan air layer forms over the Sahara Desert and moves across the North Atlantic every 3 to 5 days from late spring to early fall, peaking in late June to mid-August, according to the US National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. It can occupy a roughly 3 kilometers thick layer in the atmosphere, the agency said. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Chandni Nevdani. For more weather updates, do like, share and subscribe our channel.